Now I'd like to enter data into PI from a Windows mobile device. What you see here is an emulator that'll let me simulate what the device looks like. First, I'm going to launch the application PimlMobile. A PI sysadmin has previously created a manual logger tour and loaded this onto the device for me. To see how to do that, see a previous video. Once PimlMobile launches, there'll be a prompt for username and password. I'm going to use a user that's been designated for data entry. After entering the username and password, I will see a list of tours. In this case, there's just one defined, but I may have a choice of many. If so, I'll select the one that I'm interested in. Once I have this highlighted, then I can click on New for a new tour run. This is actually just an instance of the run. I'm actually going to take the data and then send it back to PI. When I click on the New button, I have an option here for the tour timestamp. This is the time that the tag values are going to be getting. I have an option of changing this or accepting this. I can change this using the arrow buttons or the clock. In this case, I'm going to accept the 1 o'clock time for my tag values. I'll say OK. Next, I'll be presented the data entry fields. I'll see the name of the tour at the top, several option buttons, tag name and description information here, units here, here's my data entry field here, and then my timestamp. Below, if there are high and low limits along with zero and span, these are seen here. In this case, this is a digital tag. I see this by a couple of ways. The name sort of tells me this, and then it says valve state, also the units. Also, the zero and span have a list of state sets. So this means I can do my data entry via a dropdown. So in this case, my valve is open on tank 43, so I'm going to select that off the pick list. I can then move on to the next tag by either hitting enter or hitting the forward button. This tag, as we see, is a numeric tag. The units are inches. I do have low and high limits. My high is 150. My hi-hat is 175. These give me some guidance on the values that I should enter. I look at my gauge, make my entry, move to the next tag. Again, this is a numeric tag. In this case, a temperature read from a gauge at this tank. Again, I have high limits, high limits. In this case, what I want to do is actually enter a value too high to demonstrate what will happen if there are data validation limits set. So I'm going to enter 136 here, even though I know the high limit is 125. When I do this, this error message comes up. It tells me what the tag is, and it tells me what the problem is, that I've exceeded the high temp. So what I'm going to do is now re-enter the value to a reasonable limit. Perhaps I misread the gauge. Now I've moved on to another set of tags that are similar, but for another tank, tank 44. In this case, this tank 44 in the field is actually out of service and not being used. So I want another option other than entering the actual tag values because none of the gauges are accurately reflecting any information. The tank is out of service. Again, I look at my drop-down, and I see there's an option down here named Equipment Fail. The person who set up the tour has provided this as another digital state that I can set for a tag to indicate that this is out of service. What we'll note is, as I move to another tag, even though this is a numeric tag, he has the option of entering this digital state value. So, for my numeric tags, I'm able to skip these, but also notate that the equipment is out of service. At this time, I note that I'm at 6 of 6 of my tags, so I'm at the end of my tour. This will be told to me if I do the arrow button here, or I can simply exit at this time. I'll click on the arrow just to demonstrate this. It says I've reached the end of the tour, and do I want to save? And I'll say yes here. If I notice now, there's an arrow button on the tour. If I open this, there's my tour run. If I had multiple tour runs, I would see each of these listed here. This shows me the timestamp of the tour run and the name. I'm done for now, so what I want to do is actually leave the manual logger application and go back and cradle my device at my PC. Note, it's important not to be in the manual logger mobile application on the device when syncing. This prevents it from syncing the data back to manual logger. Now that I'm out of manual logger mobile on the device, I'm going to cradle. Again, I'm using a device emulator, so I'm going to select this option here. It says cradle. This simulates me actually physically docking the device into a cradle that's attached to the PC. When I do that, what's going to happen is I will automatically sync back to manual logger on the PC. This happens because this has been previously set up. I'll see this prompt here for my auto sync confirmation. In addition, I will see the Windows Mobile Device Center. This is the Windows syncing part of the scheme. I'll see this come up as well. None of these require any interaction from me. These are just notifications. I'll see logging here that tells me I'm transferring the data. And if I see no errors, I can feel assured that it's been successfully synced to PimlMobile. Once that happens, the auto-sync shuts down. Once the syncing is complete, it's safe to uncradle the device. I've done this many times before, so I'm assured that the PI data has gone into PI. But for demonstration purposes, let's go look at it. For this, I'll use ProcessBook. I'll just create a quick display to look at some of the data values. My tags were all prefaced with PimlMobile, so that makes them easy to find. So I'll pick this first value, say OK. Let me change that, make that a little bit easier to read, and also include the timestamp and the tag name. Okay, so I can do the same for some of the other values. I'll do this simply by copying and pasting this, changing the tag name. So again, what I see here is each of the values that I entered. In the case of the valve state, I set that to open. For my tank level, I set that to 32, the units were inches. For my temperature, I set that to 110, that was degrees F. That was the temperature of the tank. And then for the level on tank 44, and also the other tags for tank 44, I set these to equipment fail. All the timestamps were 1 p.m. This is what I set when I started the tour.